Saturday night, having their mass at St. Mark and also St. James in Driftwood. We've been discussing the past on council and calling people, and I've been talking with Pastor, come on, Father, Ross Maselli, who is the dean for the area. And what we're going to do is move up the St. Mark Mass at 4 to 4 o'clock. So this is April 2nd. The St. Mark Mass will move to, from 4:15 to 4 o'clock. And then I'm going to jump in the car right away and get down as quick as I can. And we're going to start Mass at St. James in Driftwood at 5:30. So it'll be 5:30 in Driftwood. That'll do without the cold. 45 minutes. So, again, it's beginning April 2nd, we're going to have Mass at St. Mark at 4 o'clock, Mass at St. James at 5:30. And then what's going to happen is Palm Sunday, we're going to have one Mass, and then, as you saw in the bulletin, Palm Sunday and Easter fall, and the schedule just won't be able to work for those 2 weeks. We're going to take 2 weeks off, we'll keep the Mass here. Well, the Easter Vigil will be a different time, but and then we will resume the both Masses on Saturday evening, Saturday, April 23rd. So at the beginning of the month, and then 2 weeks off, and then another, then two in April. So April 2nd and April 23rd, it'll be again 4 o'clock St. Mark and 5:30 St. James. Sunday morning liturgies will stay here at 9 o'clock.
Give us our sins, bring us all to a relaxing life.
Lord, have mercy.
God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness. May we, who are bowed down by our conscience, may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
As I told before, last week was about Abraham, the covenant of Abraham. This week it's about Moses. I think it's like the holiest reading of the Old Testament about of Moses. And let's open our ears and hearts to hear the word of God.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian. Leading the flock across the desert, he came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There, an angel of the Lord appeared to Moses in fire flaming out of a bush. As he looked on, he was surprised to see that the bush, though on fire, was not consumed. So Moses decided, I must go over to look at this remarkable sight and see why this bush is not burned. When the Lord saw him coming over to look at it more closely, God called out to him from the bush, Moses, Moses. He answered, Here I am. God said, Come no nearer. Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. I am the God of your fathers, he continued. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look at God. But the Lord said, I have witnessed the affliction of my people in Egypt, and have heard their cry of complaint against their slave drivers. So I know well what they are suffering. Therefore, I have come down to rescue them from the hands of the Egyptians, and lead them out of that land into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey. Moses said to God, But when I go to the Israelites and say to them, The God of your fathers has sent me to you, if they ask me what is his name, what am I to tell them? God replied, I am who am. Then he added, This is what you shall tell the Israelites, I am sent me to you. God spoke further to Moses, Thus shall you say to the Israelites, The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever. Thus am I to be remembered through all generations. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all under the cloud and all passed through the sea. And all of them were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea. All ate the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink. For they drank from a spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was the Christ. Yet God was not pleased with most of them, for they were struck down in the desert. These things happened as examples for us, so that we might not desire evil things as they did. Do not grumble as some of them did, and suffer death by the destroyer. These things happened to them as an example, and they have been written down as a warning to us, upon whom the end of the ages has come. Therefore, whoever thinks he is standing secure should take care not to fall. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to them in reply, "Do you think because these Galileans suffered in this way that they were greater sinners than all the other Galileans? By no means. I tell you, if you do not repent, you will all perish as they did." Or those 18 people who were killed when the Tower of Siloam fell upon them, do you think they were more guilty than everyone else who lived in Jerusalem? By no means. I tell you, if you do not repent, you will all perish as they did. And he told them a parable. There was once a person who had a fig tree planted in his orchard. And when he came in search of fruit and found none, he said to the gardener, "For 3 years, now I have come in search of fruit on this fig tree, but have found none. So cut it down. Why should it exhaust the soil?" He said in reply, "Sir, leave it, for this year also I shall cultivate around it and fertilize it. It may bear fruit in the future. If it doesn't bear fruit, you can cut it down. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, so we have quote from Pope Francis that we're following with the Holy Spirit. We need the ever new breath of God, the Spirit, who sets us free from every form of self-absorption, revives what is lacking life, loosens the shackles and spreads joy. So the Spirit of God is helping us this Lent season, not to be so stuck on ourselves, but reaching out to others and also being free and having joy. Some good things and goals for Lent is our Lenten mission statement. Okay, then the question of the week. I've been thinking and thinking about this one. Name a time when you gave someone another chance, or describe how you feel when someone forgives you. Describe how you feel when someone forgives you. Well, I'll talk about that. Usually I'm all worried about calling somebody about something. You know, whether it is, oh, they're mad about something, upset about something, give them a call, or whether it's personal, whether it's like what I did as a priest, you know. And always I'm like worked up for like weeks, you know, days, weeks, whatever it is, like, oh geez, you're getting mad at me, oh geez, how come what's so wrong with me? And next thing you know, it seems like the call is in, don't worry about it, no problem, it wasn't a big deal. And so how do I feel? I'm relieved. So I keep thinking about that when I gave someone another chance. I'm sure I do it all the time, and sometimes people like, can you see me worked up with me, do it, Father Paul, I mean to tell you, don't do me, that you don't be upset about this, and I'm usually like, oh, no, it's okay, you know. But isn't it a nice feeling when you get to that point and say, oh, that really feels good, you know, that really feels good that that person's not mad at me anymore or whatever it may be. So you can answer that question in your discussion room on your own. So this reading, you know, this gospel reading, it talks about these terrible tragedies that occurred. People were killed or whatever, and you know, Jesus uses an opportunity to say, repent, you know, unless you repent, you won't suffer the same fate. You know, that makes it hard to think about that. Lent is telling us to repent, and inside ourselves we're like, well, you know, I'm a good guy, I don't do anything wrong, you know, what do I got to repent of? You know, we think that, you know, we want to deceive ourselves, but I'm thinking about this, and for me it's like, if I'm going to get that way, I keep digging and digging, you know, like maybe, like right now, you might sit there and say, okay, what am I going to repent of? Well, nothing more than the usual, right? You know, impatient, or talk about people, or whatever that may be, and then, you know, I'm going to tell you this. We got a few more weeks of Lent, and if you can't come up with something good, you know, that's real, that's like deep down inside of you, like what are you, you know, how are you missing the mark? That's what the word repentance really means, or conversion, missing the mark. How are you missing the mark? How come you're not head on with what you're supposed to be doing? If you can't come up with that, just sit with it the next few weeks. Just keep asking yourself, okay, you know, all right. Ask the Holy Spirit again, Lord, help me repent. How am I missing the mark? And I believe by the time you get to that confession in a couple of weeks, that he'll give you an answer. Unless you repent, you know there's consequences. So then we get this parable then about the fig tree. And, you know, it's about this gardener that says, you know, okay, the owner says, okay, I've tried 3 years for this fig tree and it hasn't given me any fruit, you know. And the guy in the end said to the gardener, said, look, I'm going to, you know, give it fertilizer, water, take really good care of it, and let's give it another year. And, you know, that made me think of, again, repenting. Maybe you're on the other side, but I got something, you know, I'm ashamed of. I got something that I really don't want to confess. I got something that I want to face up to. And I'm going to be stubborn. I'm not going to confess it, I'm not going to bring it up, I'm going to deny it, you know, put it in my subconscious or just start, you know, doing anything else but facing up to this sin that's inside of me. And then there's the Lord saying, give it another year, give it another year, give it some more time. You know, in this regard, again, give it a few weeks before Easter. And, you know, Lord, help me let go of my stubbornness. Help me let go of my blindness. Help me truly repent. So keep praying about it, and God, you know, will be there to melt your stubbornness. So we pray today that repentance would be something that bears fruit. You know that then we'll start to do with this in this in Easter time. So Lord, help us during this time. Help us to truly repent, to see these areas that maybe we are slow to see, slow to admit, and give us your grace and the Holy Spirit to help us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from God, begotten and not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, our salvation, came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, as incarnate of the Virgin Mary, became man. For our sake, he was crucified in Pontius Pilate, suffered death, and was buried. Rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and seats the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father and the Son. The Father and the Son is adored and glorified. He spoke of through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God, his promises, and he is there for us and for the world, we present our prayers.
Our response will be, Holy Spirit, lead us. For Pope Francis, Bishop Persico, and all church leaders, that they continually strive to model their lives on Christ, being servants of God and others, we pray. Holy Spirit, lead us. For the gift of peace, that God will open new opportunities for dialogue between conflicting parties, especially for those in the Ukraine, and help them find ways that will benefit all people with better lives, we pray. Holy Spirit, lead us. For the areas of our lives that do not produce fruit, that Christ will prune us, nurture us, and help us bear a harvest of faith, hope, and love, we pray. Holy Spirit, lead us. For the grace to experience everything as a gift, that in knowing God as the source of all existence, we may appreciate each day and each breath as a loving gift from God, we pray. Holy Spirit, lead us. For St. Mark's second graders, Emma Brown, Jax Brown, Karen Cook, J.J. Fregali, Ella Cummings, M.J. Spaith, and Harper Stewart, who received their first reconciliation this weekend, and to Karen Cook, daughter of Douglas Cook II and Alexis Narby, who received holy baptism with her class. May you all experience the great gift of the Holy Spirit as you move forward in your faith, we pray. Holy Spirit, lead us. For greater reverence for human life, particularly those advanced in years and dealing with infirmities, that God will guide us in assisting and affirming them, we pray. Holy Spirit, lead us. For our community churches, especially from Pastor Lionel Owen and members of Emporium Alliance Church. We also pray for Father Felix and the members of San Antonio, our sister parish in the Yucatan. May the Holy Spirit guide them during this Lenten season. We pray.
Holy Spirit, guide us.
For our beloved deceased, especially for Judy Erskine, who passed away recently, and for the living and deceased members of St. Mark, St. James Parish, who we remember in a special way at this liturgy, and for all who have died recently, may they experience the love and mercy of Jesus and rest in his heavenly peace. We pray.
Holy Spirit, lead us.
And for any special intentions you wish to voice. We pray.
Holy Spirit,
lead us. And at this time, please join Father Paul with a prayer for the Ukraine.
God, we need you. We always have. You are our source of strength. Tell us to give you all our concerns. Bring protection and healing to the people of the Ukraine. Show them that you are with them and that you hear their prayers. Please strengthen everyone who is feeling hurt, alone, or broken. Replace anxiety, fear, and uncertainty with your peace and hope. Please change stubborn hearts and this senselessness as soon as possible. Draw near to us and draw near to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
pardon for our own sins. May take care to forgive our neighbor through Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Mystery of faith.
I'm tired of you, Lord.
We offer what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with the very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May make your church a sign of unity and instrument of your peace among all people, and may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, Lawrence, our Bishop, all bishops and entire people. Just as you gather us now at the table of your Son, so gather us together with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, when they merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Right. As we receive this pledge of things yet hidden in heaven and nourished while still on earth with a bread that comes from on high, humbly we entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, yes, and tomorrow we have a special event, believe it or not. Right after Mass, we're going to have pancakes and sausage, I think, yeah? And then we're going to have a special called Parish Family Event. And with a special speaker, Nick Heiss. I don't know if you know him, he's a youth minister at St. Mary's, and some people know him from town here. He's not from here, but anyways, he's an amazing enthusiastic guy. And he'll be here talking and doing activities and stuff. So that's tomorrow. Come down after 9 o'clock Mass, come 10 o'clock-ish if you'd like. And, you know, eat some pancakes and then have some Lenten experiences. Okay, very good. Okay, then downstairs immediately now, right now, we'll be heading downstairs for the Chosen episode on when Nicodemus comes to Jesus and all kinds of other things. And we'll have pizza, popcorn, smell the popcorn, and people have been bringing some great food. So that's right now. Next 2 weeks, and then next week is going to be the woman at the well. So that's really cool one too. Anyway, so pastoral councils on Monday. We're meeting in pastoral council on Monday. This week, Stations of the Cross, Wednesday, it's going to be back at the 5:30 time. Stations of the Cross at 5:30. And then, again, on Wednesday, confessions at 6 o'clock. Also, confessions on Saturday at 3:15. The Lord be with you. God's blessings upon you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thank you.